it's almost like we need to redistribute the wealth is what they think. But my family and I don't agree with that. I picked up this bumper sticker. I'm a visual learner. I'll just read it to you. It says, I'll keep my guns, freedom, and money. You can keep the change. And it's got a picture of a Russian sickle. And again, we used to think it's going away. Communism is going away. But to me, it's trying to come back. And the health care issue is another thing. You can't try to help all the illegals and everybody have health care. I used to be able to get health care. If I didn't have any money, my wife and I would figure out how to get the kids health care. But again, I also picked up another bumper sticker and it says, if you think health care is expensive now, wait until it's free. So again, I don't think they're representing us correctly. Congress, we need to get somebody in there that says we're fiscal conservative, we care about how things are spent, we're not going to keep spending. The only thing the federal government is supposed to do is protect us on our borders and against enemies, not micromanage our lives and tell us how we're supposed to live and how we can breathe. And if we get sick, maybe they'll treat us like they do in Canada. I had a relative in Canada, she got cancer, they just told her, sorry, you're gone. We can't help you anymore. She died about a few months later. But at least in America, you know, you can try and pay money if you have it, or figure out a way you might be able to get your health care. Okay, so one of the models I have, some people say this is too religious, but to me, you've got to have strong values if you're in Congress. So you don't just run around and get corrupted and get bribed by everybody that comes along. So one of my favorite models, and I work on the reservations, and sheep are a big deal. So I got down, the Lord is my shepherd. He watches me like a hawk. If you vote for me, I'll be your eyes, ears, and mouth in Congress. Now, some of the Navajos love this, and some of them are going, hey, don't get religious on me. But, you know what? We need to have somebody in there that has strong values that sticks up to what we believe in Arizona. We just don't waffle here and give into that group, give into this group. We need to have strong beliefs and stick to what we believe in, and we need to represent the people. When I knock on doors, they want somebody they can trust. I don't care if it's independent, Republican, or Democrat. They want somebody they can trust. So vote for Jensen in August. Thank you.
Okay, before we get to the next candidate, I wanted to let everybody know that if you have any questions that you would like asked of any one of these, or all of these candidates, for them to answer, please write them down and submit them to your county chairman. Those will be the questions that we will be asking these candidates. These questions are meant and will come from you. So please think of your questions and please write them down. And during the stretch break after the opening statements, please find your county chair and submit those questions to them. That includes me. All right, now we're moving to the next candidate. Please welcome Joe Jaruzelski.
So I'm going to ask you a couple questions. On a third question, you've got to be loud, and I'm going to give you the answer. It's rats. And maybe you're a good Republican crew. You've heard this before. But what's the last four letters in the word American? It's ICANN. What's the last four letters in the word Republican? ICANN. The last four letters in the word Democrat is rats. And we got to get the rats out of the barn this morning. My name is Joe Jaruzelski, OJ44.com. I am a father of five. I've been married to my wife for 20 years. The first question is, what's this guy standing up here for? It's moral outrage. That's why a weird guy from Cottonwood, Arizona stands up and says, I don't like what's going on. I run the clinics for my wife. She's a pediatrician. So when I talk to you about Obamacare, illegal immigration, and small business concerns, I'm not just talking about it. I'm living it. I'm not politically connected, or am I pretending to be? As a matter of fact, you PCs out there will appreciate, I had 1,345 signatures. Of the 1,300, 1,100 of those signatures were done door to door. I know all the tricks of the trade, let me tell you. And some doors stand out more than others. And I was knocking on one door one day, and a lady came out, and her name is Kay Hinks. And Kay said to me, after a while, she said, Joe, you're wasting your time. They're all in it for the money. Needless to say, it took a while to get that signature.